You gotta give me some credit. There's a system that is kind of fun in Notion. Josh Red made this video about the perspectives method, and I've been running with this thing for a second here, and I'm not actually sure whether that video I'm talking about, that system, is gonna be out yet, but I'm gonna give you a preview of what the whole thing looks like in this really big template I'm about to drop by showing you a GTD dashboard within it. So if we go in here, this system is pretty cool in the sense that you can navigate throughout this entire structure, but that's just a sneak peek at what we got. Y'all are here for GTD. So in GTD, you're probably familiar with the top five different sections of it, which are capture, clarify, organize, review, and engage. So what we can do in this system is create those different steps and have a simple way to navigate between the different views. So let's get right into it. The core crux of what you're gonna need is a system that would have a task database. So as you can see in the back end here, I've made a task and event database that works with this. So all that we're gonna want to have is some properties here. So obviously we like our little assigned to, we like our time, we like a due date, whether it's a task and event. And then what we can do is we can add some priority to the system. So all I'm gonna do here, put a little select property for priority and change the numbering here. So we have high, medium, and low, which is built into the system that I've got the template for you, but we can add another layer to it. So we can do like priority one, priority two, then three and four. And you could even rename these different things in ways that you wanted, right? So priority one and two are like now, and then, you know, you could just have it be three of them and you can change one of these to future thinking. It's really up to what your opinion is on how many priority levels you want. So I'm gonna just actually set it to three different things here for priority one, two, and future. So within this cool system that I made, basically I can take different views from that task and events page and set it to this pin navigation bar, then sort it in certain ways. So for example, I'm in the settings page and I got this new custom one here. I can go to my task and events page and I'm gonna copy this link. Now, granted the different steps of GTD as mentioned earlier, I can take this new page and call it capture and make it the simplest view to capture different tasks. I create this linked view. In my opinion, the most simple thing would be to take a table view, since you can kind of quickly capture things and it won't open up an extra page from a side peek or a center peek perspective. And I can take the most important aspects of it and put it right here. So I'm gonna get rid of any filtering that was on the back end. So let's just do this. So essentially what we're gonna have here is this is time is empty, status is unchecked, and this essentially puts us in a spot where we don't really have anything figured out on, okay, is this, what time is this? Is this checked off? All those different things. So I can move all the different parts of it that would make sense to capture very easily here. So if I just keep going here, get all the different components of it right here. So let's hide everything else contextually that doesn't make sense. All right. So now I'm gonna actually add another layer to this too. Time is empty and priority is empty. The reason for this is essentially once I have it figured out, like, okay, who's it assigned to? What time is it supposed to be? And what is the priority? Then it will go to another view. So I'm gonna do a different emoji for capture. And then in this backend settings page, I can literally put the different steps of the process. So if we want to order it in whatever way we want. So I'm gonna set this one to pinned. And then let's put this at the very top of the list. So then if we go here, you see that we can easily go to the capture section. And a property that could actually be really useful too for the capturing is if, say, you look at the created time, we can sort it based off like when it was created. So we know like top to bottom, when was it created, right? And then maybe we can put like the time, and then we have it filtered so that it would prevent having the time and priority in there. So yeah, we can do both of these just as like, just in case we're like a step or two in. So let's do a couple example tasks. So let's record videos this time. And we're actually gonna do one other edit to this filter. This is my bad on this, but we're gonna change this to time is empty or priority is empty. So that requires all of this to be filled out before anything would happen. So we do time here and then priority, and then it would go away. So let's do some examples. So record videos at this time, make a new recipe, record a course. Now another filter you could add, if this contextually makes sense for you, would be something along these lines. You could set it so that, say for example, you put things off to the future and they aren't priority one or two, they could completely skip the action stage or like another place altogether. And this would kind of make the system work in a sense that it would have capture and clarify on the same page, because you're capturing things here, sure, but you're also clarifying the time and the priority on this page too. So let's do capture and clarify. So capture and clarify, because these are all going to be assigned to me, so I can just clarify that really quick. And if you want to get excessive with this, you could also say and organize. So we might actually just rename something like this to inbox. I just wanted to go through the entire step-by-step process and showcase to you that this is kind of how it would go down. So sorry for being a little tease and then going back into it. So we can just essentially name this inbox and then put like steps one through three if you really care about knowing what GTD steps they are. And then on this page, you can rename it to engage if you want to keep with the lingo. of GTD. But essentially what this can be is whatever kind of views that you want contextually for the task that you end up doing. This is a view that I really like, that's like my day, my today, my tomorrow. But if you want, you can set it up in different ways. So for example, you can change this filtering to be more so a priority system rather than today and tomorrow. So let's just duplicate this view and bring this down here to show you two options from a GTD more perspective. So let's do this. Let's showcase in the properties here, the priority first and foremost. It's gonna be sorted then by time and then priority, because in my opinion, when it needs to get done is obviously above it. Because if it's an event, you know, like if you got to go to the doctor's at 12:30, like you got to go to the doctor's at 12:30. I don't know what to tell you. And then it'd be sorted by priority. And then filtering wise, you can just set this up so that it's filtered to, doesn't have to be today, but assigned is me. And then priority is one or two. And then you know, change the section to actions or top priorities, whatever you want. Or you can even change it to now. And then I'm going to move this guy over here and change the emoji to a arrow moving forward, because this is going to signify, change this now to, if you want to now, change this one to later. And then in this filter, what we just do is really quickly change this to future. This could give a very basic symbol of like, all right, what task do I need to do now? What task do I need to do later? And you can see in the inbox section, if I were to put this as a one, put this as a two, take this as future. And obviously, like I mentioned earlier, you could just set it to have it be a future property. And how you do that, be this, where status is unchecked, turn this into a group, do an or, put this into a group, do or, and then just follow along with me. Status is unchecked, priority is empty. And then you do the exact same thing, but under here, we add like nestled groups. So you just put or, priority is not future. So essentially what this logic would mean. And then you can put a little and over here, and this entire system will work like this. If it turns into not having a time, but there is a future, it'll go away. If there's a time and a priority set to it, it'll also go away. If it's checked off, it'll also go away. And all this different stuff will capture, clarify, organize all this stuff at the beginning of the process. So then, for example, when we go to engage, we can quickly see everything put into its proper place. Now, if I put a future here, you see that it knocks it right into here. And that is a way for you to sort of categorize your different priorities very easily in one inbox view, and then quickly navigate between that inbox and the engage section back and forth. And then if you wanted to say, for example, take the opposite of these views and sort of look at what you have completed, go to like a review page, paste this in here. So if I filter this to and is checked, you'll see that, for example, if I do this in the review section, you can see what has been checked off. You can segment that by different days. You can look at it from a calendar view. Like for example, if I take this guy, drop it into a little bit of a calendar view right here, you can see things that were completed within a view like this. And if you want to get rid of the callout, it'll just take up the whole section. And this is a very nice and simple navigation system that takes all these different aspects of GTD into account. If you want to see more videos with this whole template setup, let me know. If you want this made as an actual template itself, let me know. And if you want to see more videos like this, check out this one right here.